Hi, it's Carly McAvoy, just talking to you today about multiplying decimals. To multiply decimals, you simply multiply the numbers as you would whole numbers. Then you place the decimal point in the answer so that the number of decimal places in the answer matches the number of decimal places in the factors of the problem. Remember, factors are the things that we're multiplying. So let's look at our examples and see if we can place the decimal points correctly. 15 and 7 tenths times 1 and 34 hundredths. If you were to multiply these numbers out, if they didn't have decimals in them, this is the answer you would get, 21,038. But we have decimals in there, so we want to count the number of decimal places in our two factors altogether, which is 3, and then we want to make sure we put the decimal point in that place so that we have 3 decimal places in our answer, 3 decimal places in our factors, 3 decimal places in our answer. So where does the decimal point belong here? 8 and 3 thousandths times 1 and 2 tenths. We have 1, 2, 3, 4 decimal places between the two factors. So our decimal point needs to go so that we have 4 decimal places in our answer. So 9 and 6,036 ten thousandths. All right, in the third example, 104.9 times 0.5. Well, we have 2 decimal places in the factors, so our decimal point should go here so that we have 2 decimal places in our answer. And finally, this last one, well, when you multiply by powers of 10, and powers of 10 are things like 10, 100, 1,000, 10,000, etc., it's pretty easy to do. You just move the decimal point to the right once for each zero. So this answer here, without having to rewrite it or do any work, I'm going to move the decimal point to the right 2 places because I'm multiplying by 100, which has 2 zeros. So if I move that to the right, I get 1456.8. And that's all I have to do. All right, have a fantastic day. We'll talk about decimals in division in the next video.